Okay, Ryan, this is a Monday. Now, I told you I'd completely reprimed this after we blocked it. Mike's getting the door jams ready. We're going to do those first, the black part of them. But this was the issue. As you can see, I've got this one here pretty close. And this one, where it had the major impact, of course, it had the dip in the... If you'll notice how it's not coming up true here, the only adjustment on these will raise and lower the whole unit. See how it's N? And this is at this gap. The best gap I can get it is right there. And this particular side is, you know, you can move this in any position you want, but, and it'll do this. Well, right in here, where it should be notching, it's real soft. It will work, but this side here, you'll notice, there's a lot, you can hear the mechanics in it. That's how it's supposed to sound into the original position. See how it's got this center pivot? Now this will adjust how high the headlights go and how low they go, but it will not raise the center of the actuator.
You don't want the headlight bucket to move side to side, so you need to pay attention to that.
I'm afraid that whoever repaired this car initially did not understand or did the best he could to make these fit. But with this being the center, there's no adjustment to move this up or down. See these holes? They're made to stay that way.
Here, it's machined.
Just another example as to why there's no adjustment in these. Okay, Ryan, I've got the other side, the side that shows in this hood, completely done and blocked and ready paint, but after having this primed, I noticed something here. As you'll see, this is the original, I assume the original sealer. It's hard, it's brittle. I'm going to have to order some of this, and I'm just going to probably try to fill most of this in, make this look a little bit better. I think there's covers, inserts that you can get, cover this all up, but we don't want to spray it, have it separating on us like it's doing here. See, it's useless, so I'm going to have to grind this out and put in some new seam sealer. Okay, Ryan, I've gone ahead and applied a new seam sealer that's made to bond this substrate to this substrate, fiberglass to fiberglass. It is a little flexible, but like I said, all of this, we'll find something. I know there's something to cover these. I've done them on a lot of cars. There's different ways to do it with insulation. There's one that's kind of a aluminum looking, and it quiets the engine sound. But what it does mainly is hide these ugly areas. You saw the way they were, and it wasn't sticking. So I put it on there really good, but I kept it below this all the way around, so we're not going to have any issues.